Introduced to the art form of karaoke. So, words to the songs that we're going to be singing tonight. And it's not important that I can't hit those high notes that I used to. What's important is that I have passion. And so, throughout this evening, I may call people up and I may sing with people and do duets, and we're just going to have a great time. All right?
Yes. All right.
Don't worry about the lack of oxygen, it'll be fine. Enough of that shit. So, because I was a castrati, and essentially when you're a castrati, you're sold into a sort of artistic slavery once your balls are chopped off. And you basically train a lot, and you don't necessarily have a lot of contact with the outside world other than other castrati. Most castratis, when they lose their bits, just kind of continue without them. I, on the other hand, held on to mine. And throughout time, he's really helped me get through some things and some real problems, and really given me that extra bit of courage to really pursue my goals. And so I'd like to introduce you to my dear friend, Tinkerballs. So everyone put your hands together. I would often look at the normal world and be like, oh, if only I could be part of that. That seems great. And this song that I'm going to sing, that we're going to sing, and some people find it to be very noble to sacrifice your art for love. I think it's something that happens quite frequently. And as a young castrati, I would often look at the normal world and be like, oh, if only I could be part of that. That seems great. And this song that I'm going to sing, that we're going to sing, really illustrates that that thought process. And I think it's something that's kind of familiar, that point where you're wondering, relationships, balls, singing, art, and you have to make those choices. And so this is a song that I think is all familiar to us, and so we should all sing it together, if possible. You ready?
Ready.
I don't know if I'm ready. Let's see. Okay. Okay. Maybe he's right. Maybe it is something the matter with me. I just don't know how world and such wonderful things could be bad. Look at this stuff. Isn't it neat? I don't fucking hear you. Wouldn't you think I'm a girl envy? Look at this trove, treasures untold. How many wonders can one ever hold? Looking around me, you think, sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets in his clothes of plenty. I've got roses and mosses galore. You want to see the box? What? What?
Love him. And so this next song will go out to Giovanni.
Water, one day Bellini swallowed a bunch of water, and All that remained of Giovanni. This is true. And so, during this time, I became very depressed. And I started thinking about my realization when I saw panic hit Giovanni's face. And in that moment, I started realizing that maybe it wasn't Giovanni who I was really in love with. Maybe I had finally found a way to claim my voice for myself. And I used to think back to my mother. Because it wasn't my mother's fault, you know, that I was castrated. She was a singer too. But back then, female singers really weren't allowed to sing because they were just considered prostitutes. So basically, I used to remember singing to herself in the kitchen and how much love she really put into it. And I started to miss that love. And I started thinking about it, thinking that maybe these talents that were given to me were given to me, and it didn't matter that it came with such horrible repercussions, that I should just be happy with the situation that I had. But by then, it was a little too late. And my voice had been completely altered. So I would sing to myself, and I would sing to my mother, about Giovanni, and about where I was. And sometimes she would sing back. And so if you clap your hands, maybe we can get her to sing with us. Clap your hands. so that's why where we are has gotten so depressing. And why me and Billy continue to go through the sea, scooping up talent and trying to find the next connection point. But the show must go on. And we must go on. I remember when I was a young castrati, and I was castrated in a pool of water. Look at my room, look at my father's face as he gathered me up in his arms and blood was pouring everywhere. And as I sat there, covered in blood, is that all there is?